I'm here in London on a beautiful day, midwinter, with Gary Arndt, and we've been talking about this new project of yours, Gary, which is a tour. Tell me about it.
Yeah, in May of 2012, I'm going to be running a tour with G Adventures, and it's going to be a travel photography oriented tour. It's going to start in San Francisco, and it's going to be a 2-week tour that goes through Yosemite National Park, John Muir National Monument, Death Valley, Las Vegas, Zion National Park, Bryce Canyon, Monument Valley, Grand Canyon, basically all of the big photography stops you'd want to hit in the American West.
I'd like to think that it was an idea that was triggered by an article which I wrote only a couple of weeks ago, which was about how bloggers now have the opportunity, since bloggers are expert travellers, to, in a sense, to brand tours. And that's, in a way, what you're doing here. But, of course, you've been planning this for some time. How did the idea come about?
Well, the idea's been around for a while. I think I initially had the idea a couple of years ago. It's just that now, with my association with G Adventures, they're able to help make it possible. I don't want to get into the tour business. That's not what I want to do. So they can handle the logistics of booking the tour, arranging everything, handling transportation and lodging. All I have to do is promote it, and when people show up, help them with their photography.
It is going to be very hands-on, isn't it? You're going to be there with them, helping them with their photography.
It's going to be probably too hands-on. you're stuck with 2 weeks with someone, a lot of driving in a van. So yeah, I'm literally going to be able to work with every single person on the trip quite a bit. Because there's going to be a maximum of 13 people on the trip, 15 with myself and the tour leader. And so literally every single person will be able to have time, and we'll be able to plan photo shoots every day, photo walks in places like Vegas.
And it'll be a live trip, won't it? In the sense that you have Wi-Fi on the van?
Oh yeah, the vans have Wi-Fi. We're going to be posting images every day. We're going to have a special website created for the tour. Mm-hmm. We're going to be working with companies as far as doing the photo hosting. And hopefully at the end of it, we'll even have kind of a final project for the group where we'll put together a photography ebook that we can do something with.
It does depart from the straightforward, here's G Adventures, it's one of their tours, you're going on it, and it's badged up as a photographic tour. It departs from that simple formula slightly, because you're also bringing in some sponsors as well.
Yeah, we're talking to different companies to provide. The two we're going to be working with to start with would be Smug Mug and Boingo Wireless. Okay. Boingo will be providing wireless access for people at their hotspots around the U.S. For the duration of the trip when you're not in the van, or that's another Wi-Fi. And Smug Mug will be providing the photo hosting for the site, and the people who are on the trip will be able to host their images with them.
Sounds like a fantastic opportunity. If it works, we assume that it will, assume people will clamor for places and it'll be a huge success. I take it you're planning to do others?
Yeah, we want to see how this one goes. We'll find out what works and what didn't, and then we can make a decision on whether we want to do another one, and if so, when and where that's going to happen. So
a similar sort of tour in the same neck of the woods, or it might be further afield?
I have no idea. One of the reasons we chose this one in the American West is because it's very photogenic. G Adventures is launching a new line of tours in North America, so this fit in well with that. And for people who are in the United States or Canada, it's a much cheaper flight to get to San Francisco than it would be to go to Kenya or something like that. So,
well, I hope you get the sunshine we've got here today, but at least it'll be a bit warmer out there.
I would hope so.